I was one of the structural engineers of the house. So initially when we were designing it from the conceptual phase, we wanted to be able to design the house in three modules. So the entire house is basically supported by this custom steel L angle that can be picked up by a crane and plotted down on any topographic area possible.
The courtyard is one of our central themes, obviously, and we have the house wrapping around it. So basically what we did to come up with a strategy for a very small footprint, for occupying a very small livable space interior, was to start occupying the exterior, and we made a courtyard with a fourth room. All of our pocket doors slide into the wall so that the balcony space and the living room space actually jut out and sort of combine. So you're actually standing in the interior and the exterior, and it's easy to go between. We've created a lot of really nice moments.
We also use an innovative material called warm board in the floor. It's a radiant heating system in which it also acts as the subfloor for the structure. And it also has tubes of running water in it that actually heat up the floor and in the environment of the inside of the house.
All of our landscape is a xeriscape, which means that you don't use any water. They'll survive on what their site gives them. Another cool thing is we've made our PVs very sexy. I think we've succeeded in not just putting sort of a flying nun's hat on a roof or on a building, but we've actually made them accentuate the gesture of the house and really work well with the house. We made a continuous plane, so they are a complement to the architecture.